This video is about Juan D’Arienzo and his music. Now, was Juan D’Arienzo an innovator of tango or traditionalist? And why is his music so important? We'll tell you all about it. Hello, welcome to our channel Tango Talks with DJ Richard. If you like our videos, you can like them. You can write something in the comments. You can also subscribe to our channel and push the bell if you want to receive notifications about our new videos. So, this video is about Juan D’Arienzo and his music, one of the big four of tango orchestras, together with Carlos Di Sarli, Aníbal, Troilo and Osvaldo Pugliese. They are the main figures of various types of tango. You have the traditional rhythmic tango with orchestras like Canaro, Donato and D’Arienzo. And there's the more melodic type of tango with Gallo, Fresedo, Di Sarli. And there is the more evolutionary, innovative type of tango which started with Julio De Caro and to which Troilo and Pugliese belong. But today we'll talk about D’Arienzo and why his music is so special and important. So, what is so specific of D’Arienzo's music? It's the focus on tempo and rhythm. It's the staccato way of playing. It's tango music that is more simple and not too complex. And the bandoneons are used as rhythm instruments, and the piano will fill in the accents in the music. And he's very well known for his sudden stops and pauses, like for instance in his versions of La Comparsita. La Comparsita in the version of Juan D’Arienzo from 1963. But we're in 63 now, we have to go a bit back in time to the beginning. So D’Arienzo was born in 1900 in the barrio of Congreso in Buenos Aires as the eldest son of Don Alberto D’Arienzo and Amalia Améndo. His parents came from Italy and they had three children, all of which were very musical. Juan played violin and became a very famous orchestra leader. His brother played the piano and drums in a jazz combo. And his sister also played piano and sang as a soprano. His father was a successful businessman in agricultural products and of course, he didn't want Juan to perceive a career as a tango musician or orchestra leader. As he said, tango had no future. He thought it would be better if Juan D’Arienzo studied law or something that he could make a decent living with. However, his mother, who was very musical herself, encouraged her children to at least study music. And so Juan D’Arienzo played violin from a young age, and when he was 12 he played violin together with Ángel D’Agostino, who would become a famous orchestra leader himself in the 1940s, and Ernesto Bianchi. And they played at the age of 12 and 13 at the local zoo in a very small theater for small money. After that he played Juan D’Arienzo, played violin in various guardia vieja orchestras, and together with D’Agostino and Bianchi he made his debut at the Teatro Nacional in 1920 with a tango cabaret and show. In the early 20s he played jazz and then returned to tango in 1926. So, what did tango sound like in the old days? Up till the mid-1920s, we had the tango vieja. The musicians learned to play their instruments themselves. It was a very small setting with a prominent role for guitar and flute. Tango was played relatively quick in a 2-2 bar or with a habanero tempo, which we all know from the milonga, the padam-pam-pam. A fine example of how tango was played in those days we can hear with Juan Maglio and his version of El Cabaret from 1913. By the time we get to the mid-20s, the Guardia Nueva begins with bigger orchestras and trained musicians. The bandoneon starts to play a prominent role. Guitar and flute are slowly disappearing and tango is played at a slower pace. The 2-2 bar gets replaced by a 4-4. Giving more room to more complex melodies. As an example of how tango was played in those days by the big orchestras like Canaro, Lomuto and Fresedo, we hear Lomuto's version of Guapito. Guapito by Francisco Lomuto from 1928. Around that time, Juan D’Arienzo also starts making his first recordings and he records for the Elektra label. As a matter of coincidence, his uncle is a major shareholder of the Elektra label, which comes in handy. He records with his orchestra and his major bandoneon player is the famous Ciriaco Ortiz. The first tango they record is with singer Carlos Dante and it's called Calajas Solo.
José Blandenga es el mejor y no hay quien tenga tu muñeca patada. Ni se conoce un cuidador con más carpeta para saber ganar. Y de Blandengue sos el mago que ha conquistado más halago. Tigre callejas no hay que hacerle, se impone tu muñeca de gran compositor.
Calejas Solo by Juan D’Arienzo with singer Carlos Dante. Carlos Dante would become a very famous singer with the orchestra of Alfredo de Angelis in the 1940s. And this specific tango would have new lyrics and be re-recorded as Nada Más by Canaro and also by D’Arienzo in 38, I believe. Another famous singer that D’Arienzo would work with in this period was Francisco Fiorentino. He would be the first important singer with the orchestra of Aníbal Troilo. In 1929, he recorded the tango Victoria, which sounds like this.
Victoria, cantemos Victoria, yo estoy en la gloria, se fue mi mujer.
Victoria, D'Arienzo and Fiorentino. And I'm not sure if this song is about a girl or about victory, or perhaps it's about street Casa Victoria, where D'Arienzo lived in his youth. They do not only record tangos, they also record other types of music, like for instance rancheras. Rancheras are a very specific type of waltz, jolly waltzes, and one of the rancheras they record is Fiesta, Asao y Cimarrón. So, tango in the 1920s and 30s, with the coming of the Guardia Nueva in the mid-20s, music becomes more complex and melodic with innovators like Julio De Caro. Another thing is that the singers become more important, singers like Carlos Gardel, like Charlo, or the female singers like Ada Falcón, who recorded with Canaro. All this means a transition for tango from music for dancing to music for listening. Radio stations become important. They have orchestras playing live for their audience. And we also see the birth of the tango movie in 1933. There's the movie Tango, which features all the major tango stars from the day. It's also the very first Argentine movie with sound, and D'Arienzo also plays a role in this movie, playing the violin together with his orchestra for a crowd of tango dancers. D'Arienzo also starred in Melodías Porteñas, a film from 1937, which also featured the big tango stars from the day. So D'Arienzo was already a big name in the 1930s. He played in movies, he played at the El Chantecler cabaret and theater, and he was also a regular at Radio El Mundo, one of the biggest radio stations for tango in Argentina. 1935 marks the tango revolution started by D'Arienzo together with Rodolfo Biaggi, as they start to record for the Victor RCA label. D'Arienzo returns to the way tango was played in the old days by the Guardia Vieja, but with the full orchestration they had at hand in those days, and without playing the habanera rhythm. So it's back to a very distinct 2-2 beat, like a metronome, bam, 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 bam. In his view, tango was all about rhythm, nerve, character, beat, impact, nuances. So he broke away from the more complex and melodic tango that was popular for listening, by, for instance, Julio De Caro. And he was also not a big fan of the tango canción with the singers like Gardel. These orchestras played the singer up front and sacrificed the rhythm for nice melodies, which was all very nice but not very good to dance to. So the bandoneons were used as a rhythm instrument, and the piano became very central in the way that tango was played by the orchestra of D’Arienzo. Now, his first recordings in 1935 he made with Lidio Fasoli on piano, and with Fasoli the revolution was not there yet. For instance, if we listen to Hotel Victoria. Victoria with Fasoli on piano. It is said that Fasoli was late every now and then for rehearsals and for performing, which was something D’Arienzo didn't quite like. And also there was another young pianist who played a lot at the Chanteclair theater, and that was Rodolfo Biaggi, who was very successful already. So D’Arienzo asked Biaggi to join his orchestra and replace Fasoli. And with Biaggi, things really started to change. You could say this was the birth of the Epoca d'Oro, the golden years for tango dancing. A very nice example of the way they sounded is from 1936. And it's called El Flete. D’Arienzo together with Rodolfo Biaggi. They recorded 40 tangos together, 18 milongas and 6 waltzes, and we tend to forget, but they also recorded 2 polkas together. You don't hear those in the milongas either. Their waltzes were very specific in style. These are falsetitos, very different from the European type of waltzes that other orchestras used to play. As an example, this is falsetito criollo. Falsetito Criollo by D’Arienzo with Biaggi in their very distinct style, type of waltzes that are very popular with dancers throughout the world. And this was really different than, for instance, the waltzes that Canaro made in that very same year. Listen to En Vos Baja, and this will take you to Vienna. In a way, way, D'Arienzo revolutionized tango and waltz, and they also played a couple of very good milongas together. One of the most famous milongas from those days is El Esquinazo. Now, most of the recordings D'Arienzo made with Bianchi were instrumentals, but there were also some with singers, not placing the singer up front, just filling in part of the song. They recorded three waltzes and a milonga together with Walter Cabral, and just one tango with Enrique Carvel, just one, but a very famous tango called Paciencia.
Ni vos sos la misma, ni yo soy el mismo. Los años, la vida, quién sabe lo que. De una vez por todas, mejor la franqueza. Yo y vos no podemos volver a nadar. Paciencia, la vida es así. Quisimos juntarnos por puro egoísmo. Y el mismo egoísmo nos muestra distinto.
Enrique Carvel in the only tango he recorded with Juan D’Arienzo, Paciencia, beautiful tango, and it's a shame that they only recorded one tango together. Enrique would go on singing live on stage with various orchestras, and in 1941 he also recorded two tangos together with pianist Horacio Salgan. He died in 1945 at just 27 years of age. Very sad. In 1938, Carvel is being replaced by one of the most famous singers that D'Arienzo worked with. It's Alberto Echagüe. This is their first recording they made together, January 38. It's called Indiferencia.
Yo también, como todos, un día tenía dinero, amigos y hogar. Nunca supe que había falsía, que el mundo sabía también traicionar. Pero cuando a mi vida tranquila llegó la primera terrible verdad, busqué apoyo en aquellos que amaba y crueles me dieron soledad.
Indiferencia, with the voice of Alberto Echagüe. In this period, Bianchi becomes very famous and very popular. So popular that, as story goes, D'Arienzo would fire him because they were performing on stage and they were performing the very famous waltz Lágrimas y Sonrisas, and Bianchi had a piano solo. The crowd went wild, he got a big round of applause, and D'Arienzo went over to him and said, "This orchestra has only one star, and that's me, and you're fired." There's an alternative version of how Bianchi left the orchestra. He wanted to start his own orchestra, and D'Arienzo was aware of this. The last tango they recorded together was Piénsalo Bien, Think Carefully Before You Take This Step, because there is no turning back. Either way, Bianchi left and started his own orchestra. The new pianist would be Juan Polito, and strangely enough, this did not change either the style or popularity of the D'Arienzo orchestra. They went on as they did before, with Juan Polito playing Lelia.
Thank you.
Lilia by Juan D’Arienzo with Juan Polito on piano, playing pretty much in the same style as Biaggi did. So Biaggi leaving the orchestra did not really change the style or popularity of D’Arienzo. This changed when Polito with Echagüe and the rest of the orchestra left in 1940. Why this happened, we will tell you in the next episode of this video. D’Arienzo's tangos from the late 1930s are very popular with lots of tango dancers. Maybe you have your own favorite by D’Arienzo from this period or perhaps later. If you have your own favorite tango by D’Arienzo or waltz or milonga, you can leave it in the comments below. So, thank you for watching. If you liked the video, you know what to do, and see you next time.